over here, and in today's video, we are now reviewing
The Eminem Show. Sorry I spoiled it for you.
The Eminem Show. Yes, we have great feelings for this album. I bet
yes,
you did.
Yes.
Because I just said you did. So,
okay, this video wouldn't be the same without me.
Or me!
Hey, shut up, Connor. Stay in the back.
Here's the cover for it. It's basically just Eminem sitting down, which basically is supposed to be like the first skit, and just perfect.
Hey, somebody put that E backwards.
Yes. And the back is also perfect. And the disc is just freaking perfect. I know I might be copying Fanboy of Lux, but it's cricket.
Family of Boo of Lux. They should call this, I have no idea what y'all are talking about, because I know nothing about music. I just know about the technical stuff of it.
All right.
Like an aux cord.
Okay.
And the data cable.
Okay,
no one cares.
Alright.
And the USB.
Let's get into the review of the Eminem Show. So the first thing we opened up with is a skit titled Curtains Up, which is basically, what we're noticing for the sound effects is basically the curtains opening, and Eminem is now on stage, but then he comes into a wheelchair, start performing the chorus to the next song. The next song is White America, which is one of the greatest openings of this album. I freaking love White America. It is great. I love the song to death.
Right.
What do you think of it?
It is a great song.
I like it when Eminem got a little bit of his own good sound in his
barn. Is he a Republican or Democrat?
I don't know.
Probably a Republican. He's not for Obama, I can tell you that.
And he's definitely not for Miss Cheney or George Bush.
What about Clinton?
No.
Yeah. Clinton, don't trust him.
Nope. I think White America's really pretty great to listen to.
White America Putin?
But the one thing I hate is that you mentioned someone named Erica.
Erica? That's your ex.
Yes, I know. I hate her so badly. The next song is Business, which is basically...
I do business. I have a business phone
which is
at
basically
home.
The first version of Without Me, but basically Eminem and Dr. Dre is like the censorship police, if that's what you call it. I think they're going to be censorship police.
Does it have to do with violent video games?
No, violent media.
Violent video games.
Yeah, violent video games.
Yeah, I'm okay with that.
Play violent video games, but no violent music. Yes.
Don't play GTA.
I like Business. I like how there's like a siren in the background for the whole time.
I work at McDonald's.
Basically just giving it like a Batman type feel. But,
Hi, welcome to McDonald's. May I take your order?
It's really, really good of a song. The next song is Cleaning Out My Closet, which...
I never do that. I got two closets.
Oh,
sorry.
We gotta do this. yes, Cleaning Out My Closet is the next song, and... I'm confused. Did this song have to be made? I mean, for goodness sakes.
This album.
The threatening things Eminem says about his mom.
Oh gosh, that's me.
He says that Haley wanted to be at her funeral. He says he hopes that she'll burn in heck. I mean, what the heck, dude? But now Eminem regrets making the song, and I totally agree with him. I wouldn't say it's one of the worst songs, though. I do like the beat for it, but it's not one of the best. The next song is Square Dance, which is basically another version of White America, but really, really funny. But, what do you think of it?
I think that I've never heard it, so I really don't know. Since we're in the country, kids, Square Dance, that's really offensive.
Y'all want to know what the heck is
going on? Come out of nowhere and say, y'all!
See my point. I like Square Dance. It goes political. He talks about George Bush.
That's
but Eminem said he's not that political of a rapper. I'm like,
why?
Why do you release songs like White America, Square Dance, Mosh?
Okay, Mosh
is a
Smosh.
We're gonna get copyrighted.
But I like Square Dance. The next thing is a skit titled The Kiss, which is basically, it's one of the best skits off of any Eminem album. Basically, this is about his assault charge, where he brought an unloaded gun into a parking lot, and threatened a bouncer, which he was charged for assault. The reason he did this was because his wife was cheating on Eminem with the bouncer, so he tried to kill him. The next song is Soldier. This song is perfect. I love this. The main thing that confuses me is why it's called Soldier.
I mean,
usually soldiers would fight for a purpose, but in this, Eminem is just fighting because he's mad or something like that.
Mad?
Which makes no real sense. I do love Soldier. The beat for it is amazing with the army marching in the background, which is amazing. Next is Say Goodbye to Hollywood.
I always
try to skip it every time I put the CD on. I don't think it's bad or anything. It's
Hollywood
song
sucks.
I really do skip. And the hook is really lazy. Say goodbye to Hollywood.
If somebody just bombed California,
what
did
you think of Say Goodbye Hollywood?
Yeah. I think that they need to fall in the ocean.
This next song is gross. The next song is Drips featuring Obie Trice.
Crazy Kingdom is out, y'all.
Now, I highly suggest,
I'll see you.
Do not ever let your parents listen to Drips. Or either Eminem's verse or Obie Trice's verse. Mainly Obie's verse, because he goes freaking explicit.
Very.
A bust of that ain't nothing.
I was right about this earlier.
Every time he says that, I
almost
die laughing.
Oh,
yeah, the song's
about
AIDS.
He had AIDS.
Basically, Obie's verse is about him making love with a woman and then he gets AIDS. Then Eminem's verse is basically him finding out his wife cheating on him with somebody, then realizing he now has AIDS.
It's just AIDS. Oh my gosh.
I bet little Jimmy knows a little bit about AIDS.
Now, this next song is easily my favorite Eminem song of all time. Yes, I said if I had was my favorite Eminem song, but I said not mine. And this song is I love it. This is very, very catchy, which I really like about it. I love the feel to it. And this is one of the only Eminem songs where I really like the music video. But I love Without Me. It's really, really freaking good. It's basically a classic for Eminem, so. And I love how in the end of the music video, Dr. Dre and Eminem have to break into that kid's house before he listens to the Eminem show. Because, it says parental advisory, explicit lyrics on there, so that's really important. Next, we have a Paul Rosenberg skit, which you can skip. Please, skip. The next song is Sing for the Moment, which I love this song.
I love it. Yep.
I love how it's samples of Dream On by Aerosmith. But the last verse for Sing for the Moment always gives me goosebumps because it's such a freaking great verse. Eminem can go deep. You know that for Rock Bottom, If I Had, Stan, many songs. But this really does show he has feelings like that, so I highly recommend it.
Not just a Britney Spears hater.
Yes. Totally. The next song is Superman. I'm gonna be honest, I don't really like this song. I don't like Eminem's romance type song. Basically like Girls Ain't Anything type song. But the problem is, Eminem makes him seem like the one that's having problems.
I have something to say about it.
Not the girl.
Great to say about it. But my mom found out I was listening to Eminem. This is the first time. She was like, oh, you mean like the song Superman? That was the first thing she mentioned. She didn't mention My Name Is anything. She just mentioned...
Not even Without Me.
No. She just mentioned Superman.
If you like Superman, cool. More power to you. I just find it.
Yeah, he's that kryptonite.
Hey. I just didn't like it that much.
Hey.
Most people really do not like this song.
I don't.
I think it's sweet. Haley's song.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that sounds kind of sweet.
I like Haley's song. It's funny. But Eminem answers the question we've all been dying for. Can Eminem sing? I can't sing. I love that line. It's so funny. But I like Haley's song. Imagine this. Steve Berman skit, which basically Steve Berman pulls a gun, which I like that.
Yeah, but please skip it.
The next song is When the Music Stops, featuring D12. It's one of the most underrated songs on the album. Even Bizarre has a good verse. N.W.N. said, F the police, now I'm in jail. But the main thing I didn't like about the song, and many D12 songs in general, that everyone talks about something else. You can have one person talk about their problems while someone else is talking about freaking famous rap music or something like that. But I do like When the Music Stops, and I love the ending where Bizarre goes, "I'm going insane. I'm holding my knife when the music stops." And he like shoots himself. I like that. I'd say Proof had the weakest verse. I like his verse. It's just really weak. Next is Say What You Say, which might be my least favorite song off the album. That's really sad to say because Dr. Dre is in this song. But I'm not going as far to say What You Say is terrible. I do like the song. It's not bad. But the chorus I really don't like. Say What You Say. Remember you said what you're saying.
Oh, great song.
Great song.
Yep.
Yes.
We got a great song here. Yep.
Right away. Silicon Labs is one of the greatest Eminem songs of all time. It's easily in my top 5 favorite songs of all time. Not in the same file, but at all time, boy.
Yep.
What the heck did I just do?
It is my favorite song in the world. I don't know if that's what it is.
I love Silicon Labs. It's very motivational, the song. And the great legend himself, Nate Dogg, is on the foot, and I freaking love it!
You know what happened one day?
I love Nate Dogg.
I was on my I was in his backyard. He has little boxing things, I forget. Box bags, I don't know what they're called. Little bag. Punch.
Punch your bag.
Simple! Okay. Well, that song came on the radio. Weirdly enough, I don't know. It was close enough. So I guess that counts. And I just started punching that punching bag while doing it.
But I love Till I Collapse. Eminem basically just attacks the mic with, like, it's sort of like Soldier, where he basically just yells and makes a quick song out of it, which I really like. The next song is My Dad's Gone Crazy. I actually really like this song. My mom thinks it's hilarious. It is funny. It's like my mother always told me. Here's a fact. To make sure Haley was able to do 97 Bonnie and Clyde, Eminem lied to Kim saying that they would be going to Chuck E. Cheese.
How did you know?
How did you know that?
Okay.
And the final skit is basically just it's curtains closed, where basically King Knip walks on stage and makes sex jokes. So, Duffy Major. And that was the Eminem Show. And this is the Eminem Show. I love the Eminem Show. Listen to the Eminem Show. Eminem Show. If you don't listen to the Eminem Show, you'll know nothing about the Eminem Show. Listen and watch the Eminem Show.
You know, he had an animated series on
It was some shady show.
Yeah, that.
That was nice. I would say the best songs on the album. I don't do best song like one song. I'd say White America, Business, Soldier,
Without Me.
I'd even say Drips. I love Drips. It's freaking awesome. I love Obie Trice. without me, sing for the moment.
Don't say Superman, don't you dare.
Till I collapse, and that's it. I'd say the most meh song on the album is Superman.
It's not bad,
but it's not perfect. I'd say the worst song on the album was Say What You Say featuring Dr. Dre. I really do dislike the song. The most overrated song would be Superman, because people think it's freaking great, but I really dislike it. The most underrated song being When the Music Stops featuring D12. And that was the Eminem Show.
You know, that whole entire song, he was trying to be a cringy musical here.
And now,
Superman. You're not reviewing that, no.
The next review is...
Why is that?
No, seriously. Yes, we will review Encore.
We?
Yes. Where are you going?
You are going through this torture with me!
We have hope to subject ourselves. For you, the freaking audience.
Imagine our torture that we go through every single day from listening to Encore.
Hey, Dad.
Imagine the freaking hatred we have.
And my dad just called me. He got some bad questions from Baghead.
Anyways, thank you all for watching this video. If you like this video, click like on this video. If you really do like the video, click like twice. Or don't. That'll make you unlike the video. So, click like 3 times, just for good measure.
I'll go
if you hang if myself. You dislike this video, go click like again. And so, me and Grayson are going to subject ourselves to the worst Eminem album in existence.
Encore.
And one of the worst rap albums in freaking existence. Encore. So,